My name is Jamie Martinson, and I'll be talking about autism today. Imagine being stuck in a body where you can't speak or communicate. You're trapped. You try to tell someone you want something, but it comes out as a scream or a grunt. You can't communicate at all. This is what it would be like from the perspective of an autistic person. Autism affects 1 in every 68 people and 1 in every 42 boys. There's strong evidence that boys are diagnosed with autism more than girls. According to autism.org, girls are less likely to be diagnosed, yet their symptoms are more severe. I live with a perfect example of this. I have a younger brother, Noah, who's 5. He is a high-functioning autistic. He could potentially develop Asperger's, which is like autism, but the symptoms are a lot milder. And my younger sibling, Haley, is only 3 years old, yet she's a low-functioning autistic, which means her symptoms are really severe. Having autistic siblings has really influenced me to think more open-mindedly and help others have a better perspective. So today I'll be talking about the stages, the diagnosis, the symptoms, and daily life of an autistic. What is autism, you may ask? Autism is a lifelong neurodevelopmental disability where people lack in social interactions and communication skills. There's many theories of why autism occurs. One of the causes of autism is hereditary, which means it's passed down from the parents. Another cause is that abnormal brain development happens, either while the mother is pregnant or because of environmental factors. So, diagnosing autism is really complex because there's an entire spectrum of how autism could be diagnosed. One side of the spectrum is high functioning and the other side is low functioning, which means one side is more severe than the other. And not all children develop at the same rates. Like, for example, my siblings, one is more severe than the other. So, the diagnosing autism involves a team of specialists. There's a pediatrician who helps with diet because textures are a big deal for them because it affects them. And psychologists help with behavior. There's speech and language therapists who help with assessing speech, communication, and learning abilities. And there's also occupational therapists who help with therapy, adapting to the environment, and bringing in special equipment. So, for example, there's these two ladies who come every Monday to my house to help, and they kind of observe my younger sibling Haley to see her progress and how she's like developing and everything. And they help her with speech and they bring toys and they just like assess her. And then, yeah. So, there's three main developmental areas. There's social interaction, language, and behavior. Social interaction is the child or person doesn't respond to their name, they have poor eye contact, and they play alone. And underneath language, there's delayed speech, they repeat words or phrases without understanding the meaning, and they can't follow simple directions, like hanging up their coat or like putting their shoes away or something like that. And also under behavior, they could rock back and forth or spin or like bang their heads on things. It depends on the severity, but they have special routines and we when they become disturbed at the slightest change, they freak out. They're also very sensitive to sound, touch, pain, and light. There's many programs in schools that help specialize in autism to help autistic children develop. Living with autism doesn't just affect the person diagnosed, it affects the whole entire family. Because my siblings are so much younger than me, I understand what it's like to care for them. Throughout the years, my little brother Noah has developed to a higher level, and he's gotten better. His behavior and interactions with other children has improved. Haley, who's three, has a twin sister, and her twin sister doesn't have autism, which is how it made it easier for us to know that something was wrong. And so while Hannah, her twin, would be like playing with toys and interacting with us, Haley would be sitting in a corner playing by herself. And when you call Haley's name, she wouldn't respond to you, like she didn't hear you. And also, going back to like the sensory thing, when you touch her or like try and hold her, she'd try and push you away because she didn't like it. So, there's no cure for autism, but that doesn't mean it can't be helped. There's many programs in schools that help support autism that help the children improve. I've learned so much about autism in the past 5 years. So autism is hard to understand, but an autistic condition that shouldn't stop them from living great lives.
I have a question. Would you ever consider becoming someone who took care of autistic children?
I could. There's a possibility. Because I can relate to it so much.
What made you decide to give speech on autism?
Because my younger siblings have it and I can relate to it.
Any other questions?
Thank you.